weekly Search Buzz video recap. Today is November 28th, and technically it's Black Friday, so I hope you get good deals. And I wanted to wish you all a happy Thanksgiving. So stay tuned for the search news, and we have a lot of stuff to tell you about. So as I said, it was Thanksgiving yesterday, November 27th. I spent some time with family. We had a nice Thanksgiving dinner. Hope you guys had a nice Thanksgiving as well for all of you who are in the U.S. who celebrate it. Google had a special logo. Yahoo had a special logo. Flash logo is pretty cute. Looks like I posted the wrong logo, so I have to fix that. Live.com had a logo, a theme. S.com had a nice theme. Dogpile, AOL, FriendFeed, Creative Site Forums. And as well as we had a nice theme. So if you have time, I'll leave the theme up all weekend and hopefully you'll be able to take a look at it. Okay, I fixed up the Yahoo logo now. It's not the vote logo, it's the Thanksgiving logo. But let's get into the search engine topics. So I wrote a post on November 26th at SEROundtable.com on why SEO should not obsess over the site command. Basically, a site command basically allows you to see how many pages are indexed of your site. So if you do site www.seroundtable.com, it will show all the pages that are supposedly indexed by the search engines. That being said, it's not always an accurate number. When you see number of results off, it's not always an accurate number. We have two ways of validating that. One is Googler John Moo wrote three reasons why it's not necessarily accurate, because it's always an approximation, one, and the previous approximation might be incorrect as opposed to the future approximation, so meaning these numbers might be incorrect in general. Also, changing algorithms might increase or decrease the number of pages Google has indexed of your site, and it's not always that accurate in terms of overall. Also, John Moo actually went ahead and posted a comment saying there's also another way to actually get good numbers is also an indexed URL count per sitemap file, which I actually wrote in my blog post. Basically, if you want to see how many pages are indexed, you can use Webmaster Tools, upload a sitemap, and it should show you the number of indexed URLs that you submitted as opposed to the ones that you submitted. So submitted URLs versus indexed URLs is pretty good. And John Moo said this count is, as far as I know, fairly accurate. So you might want to use that. In addition, Microsoft Jeremiah, who works on the Webmaster Tools team over there, said it's problematic to use the site command operator to determine how many pages for a site are included in the live search index. The site operator generates an estimate of the pages in the index. These numbers can be very, very wildly depending on when you actually execute that query. So if you do today at 3 o'clock versus tomorrow, today at 6 o'clock, it might vary differently, which shows to me that, these site command operators are not so great. Obviously, figuring out how many pages of your index are indexed in a certain search engine is important in determining how healthy your site is in terms of crawlability and how well Google and how many pages a Google or a search engine might filter out your pages. But you have to use something that's accurate, and it seems like Google using site commands in both Google, Yahoo, or any of the other search engines are not 100% accurate. Obviously, you want to use the Webmaster Tools to get more accurate data, but even then, it might not be 100% accurate. So just be cautious in terms of using that site command. So on November 25th, I wrote a pretty controversial post that got some people upset, specifically the people at WeBuildPages. Sorry about that. It wasn't really meant to be pointed at you, but WeBuildPages basically wrote that they're no longer going to do they're not going to go ahead and buy links to as part of their link building campaign. WeBuildPages is one of the most, well-known link building companies in the industry, and they've been big in terms of buying links, and now they're changing their model to not buy links. So I wrote, based on that, and that got me on the topic of saying, when did link building companies come known as, in some sense, people are figuring link building companies to be black hat SEOs, and back in the day, obviously, buying links, 4, 5, 6 years ago was not considered black hat. Now, obviously, you buy links, it's very bad, Google doesn't like it, and it has moved over to the black hat realm. But overall, now that's kind of creeping on link building. If you try to build links, and the way you build the links, might not be necessarily for the purposes of improving, a website. Let's say, Google wants natural links. Google wants people who build, not necessarily buildings, but have, they want to search the web and find people who link to people naturally, not by people encouraging others to link to you, not by an SEO trying to get links on websites to increase the page rank or increase the ranking of a particular web page, but they want links that are naturally given. That being said, link building companies, in a sense, I think according to Google, have really shifted more towards the black hat side, and this has happened over the course of the years. And I don't know exactly when it has. I've given some historical posts that show this, Obviously, paid links, I would think everybody agree would be more towards the black hat. It's not doing hacking or anything. It's not hacking a website or anything like that. But yet, I think it's been perceived by the SEO community as well as the the webmaster industry in general that link building companies are more towards the black hat. And I'm currently wondering why and when this actually happened. All right, so now I'm going to fly through topics, hopefully. Google AdWords has now given some advertisers the ability to specify which types of devices they want their ads to show up. So do they want to show their ads on desktops and laptops, or do they want to show their ads on iPhones or other mobile devices? So now you can actually specify, I want my ads to only show up on desktops and not mobile devices. This is not available to everybody. It seems like it's under a beta test right now. I have a post on it on November 27th at SEORoundtable.com. Yahoo has announced an update last Friday or over the weekend. Not much discussion over it, but there are now more discussions around it. So if you saw your rankings change at Yahoo, it is something that other people are noticing. If you want to read more about it, go to November 24th at SEORoundtable.com. Live Search announced this week that they added a new features to their Live Search webmaster tools. Now they add malware reporting. So basically, if you have malware on your website, Live Search Webmaster Tools will notify you in the reporting tools that they have there. In addition, if you are linking out to any pages that might be that might have malware on it, Live Search Webmaster Tools will tell you. Google has made enhancements to their Google Maps. They improved street maps. Now they have the Pegman, which you actually drag from the top left of the page down to any point of the map you want to actually see a street view. They also made some other minor modifications, which people overall really like. So if you want to see more about that, check out November 26th at seroundtable.com. So we've been hearing reports this week about Google laying off their employees or workers or staff. Turns out that a post at WebGuild said 10,000 workers are being laid off by Google over the course of who knows how long. Turns out that it's really contractors that Google is no longer contracting, I guess, because of the economic times. They want to significantly reduce the number of contractors they have, which might be about 10,000 workers. So it's pretty interesting that these economic times are actually impacting Google as well. So part of that is we have a post on November 26th asking, will Google be giving out holiday gifts this year? Because of the bad economic times, Google might not. I mean, people are assuming that maybe Google might not be giving out holiday gifts, or maybe the holiday gifts will be a lot less than they were in the past. Looking into historically how Google has been giving out these holiday gifts, in 2005 they gave out like a package of Google computer gadgets like Minnie Mouse, flashcards, all these cool little neat gadgets that I sometimes use today. In addition, 2006 they gave out these really neat digital picture frames, which I have one on my desk over there. And then in 2007, they gave out only these flashcards, which was a little bit stingy, according to a lot of people. And now people are worried that in 2008, they're going to be even stingier because of the economic times. It's hard to say. I wouldn't expect much, but you never know. Typically, publishers and advertisers get their presents from Google anywhere between now and the middle of December. So I guess we'll keep track and we'll let you know what happens. Good news for the search industry. Sempo, the organization behind the search engine marketing industry, which was launched, I think, sometime back in 2003, maybe 2004, has been invited on December 1st to ring the bell at the NASDAQ. I'll give you a little search tip, especially because it's the holiday season and a lot of you will be buying presents for either family or friends or significant others. On November 25th, I wrote a fairly detailed post on how to use Live Search. You go to Live Search, and how do you actually use Live Search to actually get 25% back after you buy something, even if it's on sale? So if you use Live Search and you want to, if you want to save 25% off, no matter what it is, you can actually use Live Search, buy something on eBay, everything is sold on eBay pretty much, and Microsoft will write you a check back for 25% of whatever you bought within 60 or 90 days. And I know people have tried this. I've personally given it a try, and I went through step by step on how this actually works. You need a Live Search cashback account, and you need a PayPal account. And outside of that, you have to make sure to search using Live Search, click on the Live Cashback Rewards, and go through that process. It's fairly easy now. It used to be much harder, but definitely something you want to do if you want to save some money this year's holiday gifts. Thank you so much for listening to the Search Buzz video recap. Again, this is the November 28th Thanksgiving special edition. Everyone have a great week, and I'll see you all next week. Again, this is Barry Schwartz from Search Buzz.